This little ninja should have been stoned a long time ago. Giving all praise to Yahweh Shemel Shabbat Shemer Kakudash. And this is a story that is was put up on YouTube. A couple of different companies, news companies, put it up out of Detroit. This one is from Fox 2 Detroit. And the title is, and I may put this up raw, Detroit car thief suspect dragged by dreadlocks, or dragged by his dreadlocks, after woman finds her own stolen car. So this little ninja right here, this little black demon right here, he stole this Jake's chick car. She has her own business, I think a boutique or whatever. What I'll do is I'll put the link in the description box. If I don't, just put this title down and it will definitely come up. Anyway, this guy steals her white, I believe it's a Mercedes. And she's looking for the car, but there's posts on Instagram and different platforms. Jake pretty much knows who stole it, so she tracked the guy down and finally found it in a parking lot. I believe it could have been in the place where she had a business, so she saw the car right there. Now this little ninja, he stole a car, and he kept it up. I think he washed the car, detailed it. He made the car his own. He just took. He said, "This is my car. This is my whip." Anyway, they found him, and he was in a barbershop. He had parked the car outside of a barbershop or whatever, and he was getting his hair did. And they pointed him out. They said, "Oh, that's the guy that got the white Mercedes, right?" So when they grabbed him, they dragged him by his dreadlocks, and he has this bewildered look on his face. Anyway, what I noticed in the video, they said he's like a known car thief. He has a car thief demon on him. It is what he does. He'll steal a car and he'll ride around the neighborhood that he stole the car. The cops was called and all that, but what happened was they had performed the citizen's arrest. You know, Jake grabbed him up. But they said in this newscast or this video, they said that he's been stealing cars for years, and he's been doing it since he was a teenager, 13, 14 or whatever. Which shows you, which the first scripture that came to my mind is Deuteronomy 21. And I'm going to go right to it. And see, you have a prison system in this country. And do you know how much tax dollars is put into the prison system? And this is part of the reason why your economy is so messed up. If you would tear down all the, or take the prison systems and turn them into housings, you can house the homeless. You know, you can leave the doors open. But these type of criminals, you were supposed to put them to death. Actually, their parents, it was the responsibility of the parents that they are to put the son to death before he involves himself in this type of activity. They said he'd been doing this since he was a teen. So I guess they put him in the system. And the thing about Esau put you in the system and let you back out of the system. Esau put you in the system and let you back out of the system. Where the scripture said just put him to death. And he's not going to change. He has to be put to death. He's not going to change. He'll go through the system. He'll do a couple of years. And when he comes out, he's going to bring more mischief to his hood. Anyway, let me just read this right quick. Deuteronomy 21:18. So if you have a stubborn child, the child might have not did anything wrong. He might have not stolen anything, committed any crime, but he's stubborn. Well, if he's stubborn, he doesn't want to go to school. I'm talking about in the modern day. Back then, you had to learn you know, learn that you were Israelite, you know? You had to keep certain, you had to keep the laws, and you had, and you were under the covenant, and this is when you really become a man, when you're 12 years old. That's why when you go to Matthew's the second chapter, around about the 42nd verse, it speaks about how the Lord got away from his parents because he was already a man pursuant to the law. That's why he made the statement, "Don't you know that I must be about my father's business?" Because he was 12 years old. That's when you became a man. Now, are you a full grown man? No. You start to do manly things, and you're under the covenant. You're under the covenant. When you're 12 years old, you are under the covenant. Can a man of 12, 13, 14 years old have a woman? You damn right. Because if you think back, when you was 11, 12 years old, you were thinking about women. At first, you were throwing rocks at the little girls around you. You didn't like them. Then when you turned 11, 12 years old, you started looking at them a different way. I know I did. You know, hey, when I was 11, 12 years old, you know, I was grabbing little girls' butts and rubbing on them and, you know, taking them behind a school bus and you know, doing what I do. You know? So that spirit is already in you. So you become a man when you're 12 years old. That's when you discover women. That's when you start liking women. Anyway, and you know not to like the boys. You know what I'm saying? You know, and we used to play 11, 12 years old. Shit, 10, 11 years old. We used to play spin the bottle. There'd be a couple of boys and a couple of girls. And if I spent the bottle and it landed on a boy, you did a redo until it landed on a girl. And you would kiss the little girl. Yeah, you give a little peck on the lips. So we were already, you know, coming up in that spirit of manhood. Now it says in Numbers that a man goes to war when he's 20. Yeah, because he's matured. He's growing up. He's maturing into a full grown man. But you are a man when you're 12 years old. Go back to Matthew's 2. Anyway, let me read this. I don't want to make this long. It says Deuteronomy 21. And so in essence, it's going to say that if you have a stubborn little boy that doesn't want to work, that doesn't want to do nothing with his life, you're supposed to put him to death. That's what it says. Now these guys, these laws are strange to us because we haven't been under these laws for thousands of years. That's why Jake got all messed up with the rape thing. And these guys that got mad at us, they didn't want to go and read it for themselves. Going to the Hebrew. They all claim to know the Hebrew. They all call on the name Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. They all say Shalom. So they know the Hebrew. Anyway, let's read this. If a man have a stubborn and rebellious son, which will not obey the voice of his father, and I guarantee you that dude does not, he wasn't listening to his mother. The father wasn't probably in his life. There was a video that was put up by Karat Zaba out of Baltimore of a mother and a son in a shootout, and the son died and the mother got shot a couple of times. She got popped a couple of times, inside joke. Well, what transpired to make that thing happen? I could never imagine having a shootout with my mother, and he wound up dying because the Most High was on her side. But the thing, what she should have did, if she was under the laws, well, you can't do that in Esau society. Esau society, that's why this is called Babylon the Great. But back in the ancient world, he would have been put to death a long time ago. He wouldn't have made it to the age of 18. He would have been stoned to death. It says, obey not thy father or thy mother, and that when they have chastened him, when they beat him, because sometimes you got to go beyond beating them, you got to kill them, will not hearken unto them. So they were beat. So this was obviously a boy. You're not going to beat a grown man of 20 years old. He's supposed to be out the house. That's in this society. Anyway, it says, then shall his father and his mother lay hold on him, and they laid hold on this guy, and bring him out unto the elders of his city, and unto the gate of his place. And they shall say unto the elders of his city, this our son is stubborn and rebellious. He will not obey our voice. He is a glutton and a drunkard. And all the men of the city shall stone him with stones, that he die. So shalt thou put away evil, because it's evil. If you're sitting around all day doing nothing with your life, that's evil. That's evil. Put evil, because he's evil. This, let me give you a picture of this guy again. This guy is evil. This is evil. This is a demon right here. This is a black demon right there. A car stealing chariot, stealing demon. And he should have been put to death a long time ago. You see that nonchalant look on that ninja's face? He don't give a shit. As soon as he get out, he gonna do the same thing all over again. His ass should have been stoned back when he was about 11, 12 years old. Let's come back. It says, and all the men of his city shall stone him with stones, that he die. So shalt thou put away put evil away from among you, and all Israel shall hear and fear. So you're supposed to talk about it. You know them parents got tired of that little nigga and put his ass to death. And then the parents be looking at that, you better do the right thing, because that's you're gonna be next. I can just imagine that. And you know that was a big thrill. That was like a pay-per-view event. You know, somebody gonna get stoned. Yeah, let me go. They be eating food and shit. People, you know, men throwing rocks at his ass. And he gonna try to dip and dodge and get hit and get up and try to run. But they're gonna follow his ass. They're gonna circle his ass. And they're gonna keep stoning him till one stone knock him in the head and he goes down and he's breathing hard. But they still gonna bury his ass in stones. And they're gonna leave him there, and then they're gonna take the stones away, then they're going to bury his ass. Thus putting away what? Evil. Evil. Thou put evil away. So two-thirds of you are evil, and you're going to be put away. Right along with the devil. Esau. The 22nd verse. And if a man have committed a sin worthy of death, and he be to be put to death, and thou hang him on a tree, his body shall not remain all night upon the tree. Another thing, back in the according to the law, you wasn't supposed to have put a nigga in an ice box for 5 months. Like James Brown, when he died, he was in an ice box for about 5 or 6 months, and then they finally buried you. You Jakes are completely out of order. You Jakes are completely out of order. Anyway, with that, I'm going to show you one more picture of this guy. Look at him real good. You can look at his face and see he has a nonchalant attitude about anything. He's been in the system, and this devil let him out the system. And this is part of the chaos, is because Esau allows him to go into the system and come back out in the system. So what they should have did, and they ain't going to put him, they ain't going to stone him. They're not going to give him the electric chair. You know, they're not going to inject him with something to kill him. They're just going to put him in the system. He's going to get out the system. He's going to do the same thing. His life is set to do mischief. You can look at him. He don't give a shit. That's why he should have got stoned years ago. Anyway, with that, I'm going to say shalom.